Casting Down Imaginations.
It's back.
September 1st, Thursday, at Sundown New Moon. And isn't it Memorial Blowing Trumpets as well? Oh, yeah, yeah. It's going down. Thank y'all for tuning in. Shalom, brothers and sisters. Most High in Christ blessed. We got a feast day coming up. Feast day coming up. Today is the deadline to get your fees in for Feast of Tabernacles. Going down here in Oklahoma. Just wanted to throw that out there. First and foremost, I'm going to say it again a couple more times. I know y'all seen the title of today's class. Or every time I say class, hit me in the back of my head. Episode is your pastor pulpit pimping.
9 times out of 10, that's what he's doing. I want to say 10 out of 10. That's what he's doing.
And just because your camp say that they Israel don't mean that they ain't pulpit pimping, charging 30% tithe. I ain't never heard nothing like that before.
It's tithes. It's tithes. It's plural, brother.
Oh, okay.
It's plural.
Uh-huh.
This is something I dealt with personally, so I know this. It's tithes. So you got to give double.
30% tithes? Crazy. Bro. You wild.
Tithe me 10.
How you going to call yourself Israel and still get caught up in tithing?
But even if it was, tithe me 10. That's how you going to say double?
Triple. But we
what?
So is your pastor okay. Pulpit pimping? That is the name of today's class. We're going to let everybody get settled. We're going to let everybody get on because we got a class for you. We're only going to play a few tracks. We're going to play like 1 or 2 songs, and we're going to hop right in.
Yep.
All right. We got DJ Emeka. That's why I want to play music. Be honest with you.
Hey, put something on. Like,
play that beautiful Israelite music.
That's just perfect, too.
Hop on the train like I'm about to attack. Eyes on a mission, no time to relax. This Bible stay on me so demons can clap. If you ain't my repentance, then niggas step back. Train is the gate and I'm walking the road.
Yes, today is tonight at sundown. It's new moon. No buying, selling, or working. You can cook.
Cause the Lord don't kill. I stand for my people, my fists in the air. No man on this earth that I ever will fear. The Lord up in heaven, that's who I'm a river.
Oh yeah, get everything you need before sundown, because once you do that, you can't buy nothing until Saturday at sundown.
Shalom.
We actually have Jesus. You need Jesus. Your pastor sold you the wrong Jesus, and you bought it. I guarantee it. And we're going to go into it. We have repented. That's why we up here. But stay on. We ain't gonna, you know, it's like the spirit. We want you to stay on and learn. We want to expose your pastor. We want to expose your Sunday church. We want you to repent. Because you haven't learned repentance yet. According to the Bible. According to this. We're going to go through the scriptures on repentance. You might not like
how you live the life of Christ. How do you live the life of Christ? You said it, so how you live it?
It sounded good. It's right.
Because you hit a teach, man. Help me out. See, we ain't... Bet you ain't gonna get no answer.
Wait a minute. Watch this.
Yeah, irritated in the back of my mind, watching the time fly by fast like a dream, and I wondering how the hell the lies into the skies. I will just pretend, and I use the truth when I fall back. Try the world already, I found out that it's all whack. Tell the devil to take that, try to debate that, cause he can't never negate that. Now it's time to deliver the facts. All my people be about to attack.
That's the truth, Christian test. Who is this? They say Jesus.
Back for that. Yeah, what you waiting for? Got a battle going on, but you afraid to go. Pass up, reach in, but it's all for show. Can't stop it when I'm all up in the Holy Ghost. Learn out the way of the heathen, or you live your life with no meaning.
To the person that said live like Christ,
live like him,
you mean live like this guy?
Answer that question. Live like him?
You want to live like this guy. Yes or no? Is this the guy you were talking about living like? So this is your Jesus.
Yep. Yep.
So do you know what this guy did? This guy's name is Caesar Bozier. He had sexual relations with his blood sister. He murdered his blood brother, and he had homosexual relationships with Leonardo da Vinci. So if you want to live like this guy, that's the reason why you people in church have sex with little boys. So just wanted to bring that out.
And you think you say, you live by faith.
What faith of what? Hold on, we having fun. Faith of what? Do you know God doesn't hear prayers of sinners? John 9:31. So if you're not keeping the Sabbath holy, God doesn't hear your prayers. If you don't, if you're a man with a not a beard on your face.
What?
Hold on, let me say this. If you're a female and you're not wearing a dress with fringes on, God doesn't hear your prayer. If you're a man without a beard on your face, God doesn't hear your prayer.
What you just said don't make no sense.
We have a Christian, a fanatic. I can't even call Christian. I can't even call Christian. We have a Sunday church going on here, y'all. I hope they stay the whole time because...
This is, hey, listen to this song. This song for you. Because Esau told you who Christ was. And that's what you believe. You believe his doctrine and everything. You don't read the Bible.
I am saved by the blood of the Lamb.
Who is the Lamb? That Esau tell you anything, you crazy.
They have no idea who Esau is.
Esau is a so-called white man. And you let him tell you anything.
SoundCloud, IUICKC. SoundCloud, IUICKC. It's on the Passover mixtape. It's called Two Thirds.
Listen, your doctrine is so retarded. I don't have to do anything. I can make it to heaven. That don't make any sense. I can be whoever I want to be, do whatever I want to do, and still make it to heaven.
So heel bound, I'm gonna need you to hit autocorrect before you actually post what you post. Please.
That's Jake right now.
We gonna start with 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9. These pastors have truly destroyed our people, y'all. We ain't even picking on this person. We want this person to repent. You see how Christianity has destroyed this person.
Hold on. So I thought compared to their doctrine, I'm not going to say you can't say you can go to hell. That's my mama told me.
You have no
scrupulous. You have no scripture, and you say the doctrine we teach is hellbound. But you just say that. You don't have no scripture. But we got a scripture for you. Got it? We got a scripture for you.
What you don't want to hear because instead you look like me. Yeah, we'll right after this. We'll bring it out on the radio.
We'll bring it out on the radio.
What it says be for thee, you don't want to hear from sea. Wake up out of your sleep and have life be come to me. We will live and beat your sleep, but no, we will not please. I'm listening to your enemy because he don't give a damn about you or me.
Is your pastor pulpit pimping?
Let me ask you that. Yep.
Every last one of them.
Yep.
You let Esau tell you anything and we can't tell you nothing. Man, that's what's wrong with our people. They want to stay asleep. And I'm not even going to... We ain't on no bashing campaign. I pray that the person is still on his periscope.
No, he just said something.
Good. All praises.
Because
let's get into scripture, because you know when the scripture opens up.
I want to say something, because he said something about the scripture. He said, it's not the scripture y'all bringing out, it's y'all don't live it. Okay, what sin is we in right now? I'll wait. What sin are we in? Because you said we don't live it. So what are we not living? And give me a scripture. When you said we in the midst of sin.
Let's bring it out. This is Proverbs. This is Proverbs chapter 4, verse 2. For doctrine. You say that our doctrine is hellbound, but watch this. This is Proverbs chapter 4, verse 2. For I give you good doctrine. Forsake ye not my law.
So we keep the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God. You call that wicked? Okay, you call that hellbound, because that's what we teach. All right.
First Corinthians.
When she saw what she or he saw the title, and got offended at the title, I bet.
That's what it was. Probably a pastor's, but we're going to keep it moving. First Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9. Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God?
The unrighteous is not going to inherit the kingdom of God. What is unrighteous? You got to believe in Jesus. I guarantee you, that's what he or she going about to put up on Periscope. Read on.
Be not deceived, neither fornicators nor idolaters.
Fornicators, those who not not married, sleeping around. Read on.
Nor idolaters, nor adulterers.
Worshiping your idols, your little ways.
Your cross.
Your cross.
Your image of white Jesus. That's idolatry.
Mm-hmm.
Nor adulterers.
Those who sleep on their husband. Wives sleep on their husband. Husbands sleep on their wives. Read.
Nor effeminate.
No effeminate. You acting like homosexual. You soft. You quick to go off. You very emotional. Nobody can't tell you nothing. Why aren't you getting upset?
Nor abusers of themselves with mankind.
Homosexual.
Nor thieves. Nor covetous.
Stealing. Want somebody else stuff. Read.
Nor drunkards. Nor revelers. Nor extortioners.
Revelers is going into excessive partying. Read.
Nor extortioners.
Extortion is going into extortion your own. What you say, officer?
What your pastor do on Sunday.
Yeah, exactly. What extortion is what your pastor do. Talking about tithes is double. That's extortion. And tithes not even monetary. Read.
The extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God.
They will not inherit the kingdom of God. You will not inherit the kingdom of God.
That's wild that everything that was mentioned here is what people that go to Sunday church do.
Mm-hmm.
They fornicate. They worship idols. They sleep over their husband or wife, especially the pastor.
Mm-hmm.
Effeminate. The choir director is gay or have effeminate traits.
Oh, a bunch of them are effeminate.
Yeah.
A bunch of them.
The abuser of themselves, man. Cause some of them are undercover gay like Eddie Longstreet.
Not today. They open up.
Yeah. You're right.
You can't judge me.
Right.
I get the same person on there talking about us. Got a bunch of homosexuals in their church. I guarantee you she ain't saying or he ain't saying nothing.
They go to the club on Saturday and go to church on Sunday.
Those still are smelling like the alcohol.
Right, drunkards. Yeah. Everything that was just listed is you can find in any Sunday church. Any Sunday church. Every Sunday church under heaven has all of these characteristics in it. That's wild. But we got a clip for you because this is what your pastor want to say, but he doesn't openly say it.
He says it in certain ways to, you ain't going to ask no questions in church. I'm going to tell you that. I asked a question in church before, and I was wondering what was wrong. Why, you know, I didn't know it was an issue. I was generally wanting to know. They got upset, and I didn't know what the upset was. I was like 17 years old. I didn't know why you were getting upset with me. I thought I did something wrong.
That's that intimidation. Maybe you'll never ask again type thing.
Right. So, watch this. Read, give us that clip.
The first one.
The first one.
Don't ask. No questions.
Yeah. This is your church.
Now, I realize that every now and again, some of you women folk, you get hot. You get bothered, and every now and again you get hot and bothered. But what I want you to do when you get that hot and you need a little relief, I want you to call me. Don't ask no questions.
What is that, Gloria?
Like
seeing you through his wisdom.
His only son.
That's church.
That's church.
Abraham didn't ask.
Hold on, stop. You heard how he used that? He said, Abraham didn't ask no questions. So you don't ask no questions. Is that how they twist that thing?
The Wayans brothers was in the spirit when they put this in their look. They know what's up.
Listen.
They know what's up.
He said, Abraham didn't ask no questions. So you don't ask no questions. Boy,
that's touch.
That's
touch.
That's church. Go ahead.
Play off.
God expects from his sheep here at the Greater Ebenezer New Revival Tree of Life Institutional Double Rock on the side of the road to Jericho Missionary Mountain Church.
What is it?
God expects
you to do. Wait, stop. She said, ain't that the truth? What is that in the Bible? They just, anything that man say, they going with.
He put, watch this, in that name of that church, he named every church in the south side or east side of the city. Every church has one or two of those names in it. I know there's some Ebenezer churches, some Mount Calvary, some Jericho, and some...
Some rock
Tree of Life.
On the side of
road to Jericho.
Outside, sitting on the grass.
He named every church in one title.
Come on, man.
Play on, man. Let's finish that off. All
right.
Who of the Lord wants you to do like those of you who realize that
he popped his mouth.
Lord wants you to give generously.
Hold on, stop. He said to those who start realizing, like when you start reading the Bible, then you start looking around and realizing, he about to check them. Pray on.
Amen. Don't ask no questions. Don't ask. How come the pastor have to have him a nice house? Why come the pastor doesn't have a nice car? Don't ask. I said, don't ask. I said, don't ask. No questions. Just give the money.
Just give the money.
But, no, keep playing.
Get the clutch play right on that side. Now get it around.
All right, cut. I had to get that part in there.
That's pulpit pimping.
That's pulpit pimping.
And if your pastor ever said, get the collection plate out, he's pulpit pimping. And I know they do it two or three times in church. And I ain't stupid.
I was in a church where they won't let you leave until they get their quota for that day. They'll keep on asking. How many of y'all know what I'm talking about? How many put the whys? Put why? For yes. They, listen, I've been in the church. They won't let you leave, bro.
Until what?
Like, if they want $1,000 for that day, oh, I'm just using that number. If they want $1,000, they'll count the money and, like, we didn't reach what we had. And they'll pass the plate again. And they will keep on talking until they get that money.
Yeah, I'm glad I never been to a church like that. Because if I'm in church, of course I'm in the world. I wasn't a nice person in the world. I would have been stealing on deacons, ushers. You gonna let me out of here? I'm not spending 5 hours in no church. I'm be swinging on people.
It would not let you leave, man.
Okay.
That's crazy.
I'll have to carry the usher with me home then. Cause she gonna be.
The women don't play. The women don't play, boy. The women in church with the white gloves.
Oh man. Revival is like what do you call it? A revival is nothing more than what a revival is, right?
Oh yeah, Bishop Martin in New Orleans, bro. This dude got helicopters, private jets, big.
Does he have a bald head?
I think so.
Is he black? Yes. And he got a goatee?
I think so.
He looked like he on crack.
I think you know the dude?
Yeah, like watch this. The other day, right, me and my wife was looking for something funny to watch. It's something called The Revelation on Netflix, right? It has all of these pastors, right? All of them. One of them from New Orleans, like his church got flooded out in New Orleans. The way they talk about God is disgusting, bro. Disgusting. But his mouth is moving like this. His eyes get big all of a sudden. I'm like, what the hell?
Because they don't know God, bro.
Either he's possessed or he on that crack demon. One of the two. Because I know a crackhead when I see one. And all I was screaming, crackhead, crackhead, crackhead.
I think he used to be a crackhead before he came in. I think he used to deal with it.
Because his mouth was like, yeah, my church got flooded out. And Tyler Perry, being a man of God, got me a church in Georgia.
Listen, Tyler Perry ain't a man of God.
No, he's not. He wears a dress.
To the person who addressed us saying we don't have God, this doctrine is on, you know, we teaching people on the way to hell, whatever. Is Tyler Perry a man of God?
I think they've been gone since scriptures came out, to be honest with you. I don't think they've been here.
Okay. Yeah, they might be gone. Okay, but he's not a man of God. And I'm going to get to why. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 22. And verse 5. See, we can prove things. You just talking. We say something and we have the scripture to back it up.
Right.
Because we read. Alright? So Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5.
Come on.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
I guarantee you, if that was a woman, she got pants on. Probably wasn't sleeping if y'all gonna pay. Read on.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So a woman should not wear pants. Read it from the top again.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Pants. Pants. The woman should not wear pants. I was looking at a movie. I forgot the name of the movie. It was a cowboy movie, whatever. They had women working, riding horses. They had dresses on. Every last one of them, the kids, everybody. Read on.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Neither should a man put on a woman's garment, meaning dress. Tyler Perry wears a dress. He's not a man of God. It's about to tell you what. It's about to tell you. Read.
for all that do so.
So all the people that do this, a woman wearing pants, a man wearing a dress, all that do so, read.
For all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
Abomination. They're abomination to the Most High God.
That means a vile, disgusting thing by those that don't know what abomination means. That is vile and disgusting to the Most High God.
And if you don't repent, you're going to hell.
You're going to die.
You're going
to
die.
You're going to die twice.
Give me that in Revelation. It's 11 and 8, 21 and 8. Because it said abominable in that, right? Because
mm-hmm.
I want that. I want them to understand that we ain't just saying, grabbing stuff out the air like y'all Christians. So, y'all, I can't call y'all Christians because y'all don't walk like that.
No, no.
Y'all don't walk like that. Y'all don't walk like the anointed ones.
Y'all are imposters, period.
That's it. Because Christ told us about y'all. Christ told us about y'all. And we read it and then we observe, okay, there you go. That's who Christ was talking about right there. Okay, I see you. The person who will forsake everything Christ said, but claim that they are Christ. I'm a Christian, but you don't look nothing like him. You don't act nothing like him. And Christ spoke about that. And y'all act like when Christ say that we read this thing, like, well, go to Peter. No, I ain't going to Peter. I'm reading what Christ said. Christ over Peter. He don't want to ordain Peter. I mean, Paul. He don't want to ordain Paul. What are you talking about? Paul didn't teach nothing different. You just don't have no understanding of Paul. That's why. But read that.
This is Revelation chapter 21, verse 8. But the fearful and unbelieving.
The fearful. You scared to keep these commandments. You scared to grow a beard. You, what they call this? The rough look.
You scared to have one wife and one wife
right.
Only.
I don't do birthdays.
Or any other man-made holiday.
You scared of that thing. Because you feel like, well, they gonna disown me. So? Christ said they was going to disown you. But you ain't living that life. You ain't living that life because you not doing Christmas. You're not doing Christmas. You're not doing all these pagan holidays or birthdays, whatever. You scared of people not wanting to be bothered, like your mom. Look. I was about to say something, we ain't gonna go do that, but read on.
But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable.
The fearful and unbelieving. We read the depiction of Christ, but you don't believe it. Oh, that's in the spirit world, brother. See, he was in the spirit world. So what depiction that the officers showed earlier, where did they got that from? Because that's nowhere in the Bible. So that's okay? Read.
And the abominable and murderer.
Wait, they go to abominable. Read that again.
And the abominable.
And the abominable.
And murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake that burneth with fire and brimstone.
And all liars. Read.
Which is the second death.
You're going to die twice.
That's scary. That is scary. I mean, when you talk to a Sunday church person, I can't call them Christian, that's what I'm going to call them, Sunday church person, they won't even consider.
Sun worshipers.
Right. They won't even consider that what they are in is wrong. Even if you bring them scripture, they will close their ears on you.
If somebody come to me with a Bible and trying to show me something, I'm going to listen. He's coming with the word of God. So I'm going to listen. Because the Bible says, he that is of God, hear God's words. I don't care who it's coming from. If he's coming with God's word, I'm going to listen. But you ready for a man to walk up to you in a doggone punk, a clothing store? God gave me a word to give you. You gonna be a millionaire. I don't know when it's gonna happen. Give me $20.
Right, you gotta put it in good ground, brother. You gotta sow a seed, brother, of $1,500.
I could have went to anybody in here. The Spirit told me to come to you.
Right,
because you gonna take that crap.
Because you have an anointing on you.
And they start doing that, you be like, oh, I gotta get this dude all my money. What is that in the scriptures? And the reason why I'm saying this, I seen it done to my mother. So I'm gonna talk about the experience I've been through. Ain't nobody can tell me otherwise. That's what I see, I'm gonna say it. I'm gonna expose their behinds. And in New Orleans, it's a lot of that. I haven't seen that a lot in Oklahoma since I've been out here, but in New Orleans, people will walk up to you in a mall. Anywhere, you could be at a gas station, pump me gas. Hey, brother, God told me to walk, coming to you. Women will do this. It was just in the spirit. You just got an aura about, the spirit is talking to me. I had one time a dude gave me money because he told him, the spirit told me to give him money. I'm like, bro, you crazy? I took that money, though. I'm like, that dude crazy. Bro, I was selling drugs at that time.
He paid you in advance. That's what it was.
I was selling drugs at that time. You can tell how confused that is? I'm like, well, hold on. Because I didn't know of course I didn't know the truth. I'm like, you know, I'm supposed to be getting stuff like this? Because I know I'm doing bad. I'm like, God told that woman to give me money.
Because she's going to need that fix at 5 o'clock. She just paid it forward. That's all it was.
Bruh, I'm telling you. I can't. Since I've been up, Christianity, it makes me sick. Because it's destroying our people. It's not helping at all.
What is that scripture that says they judge for hire? Let me get that. And then we're going to play another clip. This is a well-known pastor. And listen to the foolishness that he do. Man. Does everybody know on this Periscope that tithing is not monetary? Type yes, Y for yes, or N for no. Please say yes. Okay.
You gave it an answer, huh?
Oh, man. Okay, just making sure. All right.
You want the clip or you want the scripture?
Oh, the scripture.
Micah
3 and 11. Okay. You got a mic on? Yeah. We got DJ Amakai in the building, y'all. Officer Amakese.
But I want to ask a question. Well, after you read that.
Micah chapter 3, verse 11. The heads thereof judge for reward.
The heads thereof judge for reward. What? Okay, come
Wait,
on.
You say Micah?
Mm-hmm.
Micah 3 and 11. And the priest therefore teach for hire.
The priest, which is your pastor, teach for hire. He ain't going to come do it for free. And he ain't teaching you nothing right anyway. He's not teaching you anything, to be honest with you. Just like those pastors in Terrell, Texas, that own a college dedicated to teach people the Bible. They charge them tuition. And if you see that debate, they have absolutely positively not one inkling of understanding. But they charge you what? $15,000 for tuition? To learn what? Nothing. Read.
And the prophets thereof divide for money.
That's why we go on Periscope. The Periscope prophets, they go, I hear a word of increase in your life. In your life. Send your money to 1-800-897-665. God bless you.
10 years later, you still pew, pew, ducking bullets.
Or you got Kearney Thompson talking about, and God, buy this personal prayer package. God told me to tell you that you need to buy this personal prayer package for $25.99, and it'll heal anything and everything. God bless you. Read on.
Yet will they lean upon the Lord and say, is not the Lord among us?
Because they'll touch you, you pass out, and they be like, oh, the spirit is moving. That's why you see on Facebook some dude just doing this and half the church fall.
Or they go run outside, eat grass.
Because y'all think the Lord is among him. Oh, he's a man of God. Did you see that?
Y'all sheep. God say y'all sheep. You a sheep. Go outside, eat the grass, because you sheep. They say you sheep.
Or tell the sisters in the front row not to wear panties.
I seen it on
what?
I seen it on Facebook. I seen it. Somebody one of the Israelite sisters posted it.
There was a pastor that told the sisters in the front row to stop wearing panties. And they did it. You see videos of women twerking in the choir?
Oh, the man who said I got the holy stuff. So let me stuff to you.
Wow.
You know what I'm talking about? Remember? The dude with the milk?
Oh, yeah. Wow, yeah. Yeah, that's...
That was on the news.
And
he made the news.
Those African, those so-called Africans, like the real so-called Africans, the Hamites,
they getting paid.
They're crazy. No, they take it to another level. Like, there was a bishop in Africa, right? Some woman said, I'm a witch for Jesus. He slapped the crap out of her in front of everybody, a packed church. He said, you a what? She said, I'm a witch for Jesus. You are a devil. Bam! Slap
him. I'm going to tell you this. At least the Africans, they're something
crazy,
about,
bro.
I mean, they wrong as hell, but at least they try to do something. They had this one couple in there who I guess they got caught having sex in the congregation, and the dude, the pastor, whooped them both.
That's wow. And then you got Reno, finish that off, officer.
Not evil can come upon us.
And that's your Creflo Dollars, that's your TD Jakes's. They just anointed of God. They can do it whatever and however, whenever, and nothing will happen to him. He can get a $65 million jet. He can get any and everything he wants.
And he speak that to y'all like y'all living like he living. Ain't no evil gonna come upon us in here.
Can you find that pimping of Creflo Dollar when he was talking about getting that jet? Cause y'all got it. Look, we gonna bring it out. Creflo Dollar is one of the best pulpit pimping pastors ever,
bro.
Ever.
He can look. He sees something his way, he'll move it and heed the commandments. He was like, you know what? These people. Because they know about us. He had to attack the commandments, God's commandments. He told his congregation the Ten Commandments are tradition.
Ooh, freaky, yo, tradition. Ah. Come on, man. If people bought it, people, yeah. Hey, man. Oh, hallelujah. Our people was checking.
Because you got to know why. You got to understand what's going on. A lot of people in that church is sick. They sick, meaning they full of sin. So you massaging it and you're not cutting it up with the scriptures and you telling them it's okay, then they'll be like, okay, I like being here. It's comfortable coming here.
Because he'll say something like this. God wants you to have $1 million house. God wants you to have $1 million car. Give me a paycheck. And nobody, it never enters into the people in the congregation's mind. How am I going to have $1 million house and $1 million car if I give you all my money? Faith. You must have faith. You got it? You found it?
I'm looking for it now.
Okay. You got another scripture you want to bring out?
Yeah, I want to look. I'm looking for get out of my way. Get you out of the way. I forgot what it was. You're talking about prophesying to be deceased. What is it?
Oh, okay, I got you. I know where it's at, Isaiah.
Oh, yeah, that's all.
Yeah, okay.
Sure. I want you to start at, what you
got? Verse 10.
Wait, hold on.
Or 9.
I want 8.
Okay, this is...
Because y'all realize, Most High, to the people who are here, you so-called Christians, you so-called Christ lovers, this is for you. This is talking about you. If you ain't keeping the commandments and offending Christ and believing that Christ is a black man, something wrong with you. Because the Bible says he's a black man. Read that.
Isaiah chapter 30, verse 8.
The Most High said this to Isaiah. Read.
Now go, write it before them in a table and note it in a book.
It's talking about the Bible. Read.
That it may be for the time to come forever and ever.
He said that it might be forever and ever, time to come forever and ever. Why he say that? Read.
That this is a rebellious people.
He said that this is a rebellious people. He talking about you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans who are the Israelites. He said you are rebellious people. Read.
That this is a rebellious people, lying children.
Lying children.
Children that will not hear the law of the Lord.
You won't hear the laws of the Lord. You won't hear the laws of the Lord. You won't listen to what God say. Read on.
Which say to the seers, see not.
He don't want to say to us, see not. Don't look at us. Read.
And to the prophets, prophesy not unto us right things.
Don't prophesy to us the laws, because that's the right things. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery. That's the right things. You should have fringes, a beard on your face. You should not eat pork, shrimp, lobster, crab. Don't tell us the right things. Read.
Speak unto us smooth things.
Tell us something smooth. Tell us that I'm going to have a porch in my future. I'm going to have a house in my future. I'm going to have a big booty fine woman in my future. The women, tell me I'm going to have a husband. You know? Tell me how. Tell me, I'm gonna have a $1 million house. Yes, no pork. Yes, no pork. They just want to hear all these fantasies. Tell me, my child won't go to the NFL. I know about that because that was my mama. Woman's off, sorry. But I stopped that because I told him about this, that we were Israelites, that we had to keep the commandments and faith in Christ. So now I got the whole family mad at me because I stopped his career in the NFL. What? Read on.
Prophesied deceit.
Lie to me. Lie. They want to be deceived. That's why you have a church that have, 30,000 members. Listen, if you tell the truth, you bring this up. Ain't no 30,000 members. No, we'll cry here. We will cry you to keep the commandments and the faith of Christ.
That's right.
That's what we'll cry of you. The guy asked me, how can I join? Keep the commandments.
Keep the commandments and the faith of Christ. That's it. It's just that simple.
Because that's what we do.
We don't need no member's fee?
No.
Ain't no member's fee here.
Yeah.
You know, if you're a member of a church, they require you to give so much each month. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to give your 10% plus your required amount as a member.
They act, listen, that's just the lowest. They want you to give, you keep 10%, give me the rest.
You know, in the back of the church behind the pulpit, I know y'all know what I'm talking about. There's like a bulletin, like a little like wooden thing on the back where it says last Sunday's tithe, and it has the amount. Last week's building fund amount. And then it shows, like, they have the amount up there.
And then they got the goal.
Right.
Where they trying to reach. The goal, they never reach the doggone goal. You know, we should go. It was like, I gave $200 last week.
Revivals have to be the biggest pulpit tool of these pastors, because revival is every day. They bring in other pastors from different churches and they split the money.
Some pastors, they pay up front. Like, if you want TD Jakes, you got to give him, like, I think it was $30,000. is to get them to come to your city. Then you got to spit
dough calls,
dough emissions, because you ain't just going to no church. You going to a doggone event center. You going to a center where you have to be charged to get in there. You got to get tickets.
Yeah, tickets.
Get your tickets today. Yeah.
God bless you. Crap, man. It's bull crap.
Read on.
Verse 11. Get you out of the way.
Get out of the way. Shut up. Y'all getting on my nerves. Read.
Turn aside out of the path.
Turn aside out of... You're in our way. Read.
Cease the Holy One of Israel to... Cause the Holy One of Israel to cease from among us.
Do they know what they're saying when they tell the prophets? Don't prophesy to us right things. You telling God not to govern you. You telling God not to be your God. Read on.
Verse 12. Wherefore, thus saith the Holy One of Israel, because ye despise this word.
Because you despise his word. Because you're not despising us. Because they got a scripture in there that says,
It's 1 Thessalonians 4 and 8. Where it says, he that despises not man, but God.
There you go. You don't despise us, you despise God. Because that's why he said it here. Read it again.
Wherefore, thus saith the Holy One of Israel, because ye despise this word, and trust in oppression, and perverseness, and stay thereon.
You stay thereon. You trust in that thing. You know something ain't right with it, but you trust in it.
You got it? We about to listen to one of the greatest pulpit pimpers ever. Ever. I'll give him that. He know how to pimp the people, but he going to die if he don't repent.
It's a news clip. It's the news clip. It's not actual him. It's the news clip.
Okay.
Is he speaking on it?
We got like a little second.
Nah, we don't want that one. Hit me a phone. Yo, what's up?
Everybody that's on it, they keep on. Everybody's just talking about it. It's not him.
He got it.
I'll find it. But, I hope I can find it. I know you did a diligent search, but.
No, y'all got to realize that every time you tell the prophets the seats, you know, don't tell you the right things. You tell the guy, look, I don't want to hear your word. I don't want to talk to you. I don't want you in my presence.
Yeah, they want that smooth talking. Officer, they want that, I'm in the midst of sin, but don't tell me I'm in sin. Don't tell me that I need to sleep with my wife only.
Tell me I'm okay.
Tell me I'm okay. Just tell me that God loves me despite that I'm cheating on my wife. Despite, you know.
We all go through stuff, brother.
Right, that's exactly what they want to hear.
We all go through it. Listen, I had struggles. Just keep hanging in there. Don't never tell them to stop doing it. That right. Is going to destroy him. You know, this why the pastor got hold on to him. He just inching down, getting his money. That's all that's happening.
Right.
That's all that's happening. Emekai, give me
guys.
You found it? Bro, it's out of here.
That's all right.
Where is it?
Give me Jeremiah 23, I think. It says, woe be to the
Yeah.
Get that.
Yeah.
Because the Most High God has recorded it in the Bible about these pastors.
You got it?
Yeah. Oh, hold on. I think so. One moment. No, that was CNN. All
right.
No,
Jeremiah.
Right.
Chapter 23, verse. Go ahead. You read it.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 23. Want to start at verse
1. Start at 1.
Verse 1. Woe be unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture.
Saith the Lord.
Saith the Lord.
So, woe means destruction. Woe means destruction, death, sorrow. to the pastors that scattered the sheep. This is the people that was diehard Sunday churchgoers, right? And now they understood that something was wrong with church. Now they in Islam. Right. Why? Because the pastor has completely destroyed their belief in this Bible.
Now this Bible is fairy tale.
Yeah, now this Bible is not what it says. Why? Because the pastor destroyed him. So guess what has to happen to him if he don't repent? He's going to be destroyed. He's going to die. So pastors want to wear Gucci nowadays, Louis Vuitton. We got a clip, and we're going to destroy this clip, y'all. You got that one that we have queued up, Mr. JML? Let's go. Listen to this. For y'all that never heard this before, this is going to be very sickening. Get next to a trash can because you might vomit. Ready.
On November 29th, 2013, JMMI paid over $6,000 to Louis Vuitton. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
What would that be for?
Well, this is for clothes concerning my TV ministry as well.
Oh, yes, for Louis Vuitton.
Oh, it don't matter what name it is. The point is...
Stop. I can't stand that soft... talking man like that.
He is super soft. Super soft.
I have to. Might make my skin crawl.
But watch this. She says, so you got to wear Louis Vuitton. The 100% Sunday church goer answer to combat anything that shows truth. It doesn't matter that it has to be Louis Vuitton.
Doesn't matter.
Like Christ is black. It doesn't matter that Christ is black. Yeah. That's their number one answer.
Come, brother. You got to keep him. Commandments. It doesn't matter about the commandments.
Right, it doesn't matter about
it. It doesn't matter about nothing dealing with these people. And they never have a scripture to prove what they're saying.
It doesn't matter. Do you know the name of that pastor right there? Is they going to say his name?
Yeah, I think they going to say his name, yeah.
Okay, come on.
I allocated to us for ministry purposes as well.
Turn it up because he's talking so soft.
You know, in a media ministry.
In a what?
Media ministry.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm on the road when I'm always traveling and using my clothes, I'm sweating through them. So I'm needing new clothes also for television ministry for the year. So.
And so you use ministry money to buy your wardrobe.
Outfit. It's allocated more towards ministry apparel.
Is that going to what your income is?
I'm sorry.
Do you show that in your income that you got Louis Vuitton clothing?
No, that's not. That's that
doesn't show.
Because it don't go there.
It don't go there. Mm-hmm. I don't know what that means.
Stop. Stop.
That's out of place.
What's out of place?
He been pimping so long. That he's giving answers that he would give to his church members, but this is Esau. This is Esau doing an internal investigation on his pastor. Those answers ain't gonna work for Esau. She is destroying this cat right now.
What?
What do you mean? What are you talking about? And he has to answer. Because if it wasn't for that, if it was just a normal church member, it would have been over a minute ago.
It would have been security men grabbing you by the neck.
Right. Big bald headed dude that sits in the bottom door.
How many pastors? They talk about their pastors, but I guarantee you, you can't go shake Creflo Dollar hand.
No.
To you members who are at his church, you can't go shake his hand. T.D. Jakes, I guarantee you, they can. The only people you see him talking to is people who movie stars, somebody.
Right.
You ain't going to. You ain't. I'm talking about a member. Like if I was a member. This is a regular old member. He ain't about to come to my house.
And in their churches, I heard that, you know how T.D. Jakes has the Potter's House, right? He teaches there once a month. He's the chief pastor. He has other pastors that do normal church service. He's there probably once a month, one Sunday out of the month.
He's getting that money.
Right.
He run around the world getting that money.
Right, so he has pastors underneath him that quote-unquote minister, you know, every other Sunday. But I think he might be there the first Sunday or something like that.
God has really blessed me. Look how big my congregation is. That's how they say God is blessing them, by how the stuff they have.
Oh, in that show I was telling you about, we better get back to the clip. If you watch on Netflix, it's called The Revelation with these pastors, right? There was this pastor, right, that it said a prophet that failed, right? Was the, like, they basically talk about like a part.
A movie or a TV show?
It's like interviews. It's a series of interviews with different pastors, right? He said they're going through like, you know, tribulations in their life, right? Tribulations in their life. One of the tribulations was, it was a sister that he said was a sister in his congregation. She was sick, right? Mm-hmm. She had cancer or something. She was like, you know, out of church for a while, but then she came back and everybody was all happy. And he stood up and said, God said your sickness would take your life. A month later, she died. A month later, she died. And now he said, I got to go back. And I had to go tell my congregation that God didn't tell me that I lied. He shouldn't have no members.
Wait, hold on. They had another pastor.
He should have no members right at
here,
all.
Right here in Oklahoma, big name pastor. He's an Edomite, but he was. I'm just showing you about how they Israel doesn't need anybody to talk to them. He said God came to him. If y'all know who I'm talking about, this was in the 80s, early 80s, or maybe late 70s. I think it was the early 80s. He came out and said that God came to him in a dream, and he said, "You don't give me $2 million." God's going to kill me. This is what he says. And guess what? Tell me he got that $2 million. So I can just say, I can just come out and God's going to kill me. Give me $2 million or he's going to kill me. And they gave him, he got more than that. He got that $2 million. I forgot to, whoever remember that, put his name out there. Right here in Oklahoma. I forgot his name, man. But these pastors are devils.
Demons, bro.
They're devils, man.
Straight up demons, man.
I ain't never seen that in my life.
And plus, how do you have a congregation and your name is Creflo Dollar?
Christ paid taxes, man. He was the Son of God.
Keep going, bro. Like, play that clip. God. Play that clip, man. Come on. Let's get some more of that. Let's get some more of that beautiful, mean coverage.
You don't get taxed on things like that. That's for ministry business purpose. So it's not.
Louis Vuitton.
Well, you can call whatever you want.
Wait, stop. Stop. That's the pimp.
You can call it whatever you want.
Listen, why you gotta worry about labels?
God don't see labels.
Man, you don't see, you call it Louis Vuitton. I call it, it's just something I sweat in.
God calls it garments.
It's a,
right.
It's a garment. This is a $2 million garment. Hey!
What do you got to say?
Money,
money.
Listen.
Money, shmoney. It doesn't mean nothing.
This is the way. He said the label do not mean nothing.
He said that's what you call it. No, that's what it's called. It's called Louis Vuitton. It's on your bank record. Do you see? Play on, man.
2014, we spent $3,500 by Jane O'Mai to Versace in the Bahamas. Mm-hmm. Yes?
I'm sure that's right. If it shows there.
And that was the closing for you?
Yes, probably. Yes, most likely.
So you don't see that there's any problem when you're ministering to the poor, the sick, the needy, to be appearing in Louis Vuitton and Versace?
Well, that ain't something I purchase all the time.
Well, it looks like you did several times in...
Person, when it comes to this, I go to the right places to get a lot of suits, and if I get some from those places, you don't see that.
I don't see Macy's.
No, you don't see that. You know, because Macy's don't have the kind of suits that I wear. But what I'm saying is, this Louis Vuitton thing, you don't see that in our charges all the time.
2013 and 14, JMMI spent over $30,000 in your clothes.
That's mm-hmm.
about
like
what year was that?
13 and 14.
Oh, God, yes, because I was traveling so much and sweating through all my clothes. Exactly.
Stop.
The problem with...
I sweat a lot of my clothes. I wash them and I'll rewear them.
I just told him to turn the fan on. It's hot and I'm sweating up.
Guess what? They make washing machines, dryers, and laundry detergent for that. But he's like, oh, yes. I sweat through all my clothes. I just couldn't wear it no more. What? You need to wear some deodorant. Some serious deodorant. You need some of that.
You sound like some of these rappers. I remember back in the day, because back in the day, they had rappers that would say, like, I wear my shirt one time. I wear underwear one time. I throw it away. I had to have packs and packs of new underwear and shirts.
Yeah, Dame Dash said that. I remember that. Dame Dash said that.
But he ain't doing that now.
Nah, I don't know. We don't know. Dave Dash fell off the face of the earth, kind of. But, play on.
Can't pull it off, because just, you know, so.
But they have to be top-of-the-line expensive ones.
No, they are not top-of-the-line clothes.
Louis Vuitton's not top-of-the-line?
No, it's not where I get my suits from.
Well, you got something from them for spend thousands and thousands.
Well, the belts are more lasting, so that's good.
Come on, you're buying belts for $5,000?
No, I mean multiple belts. Not
August 2014, we went to the Gucci store in Troy and purchased something.
Yeah, like I gotta say, it probably was a belt or...
Stop.
Maybe.
His explanation about going to Gucci, Louis Vuitton, Versace is to buy belts. Thousands of dollars of belts. How many belts do you need?
He's switching it up because he's lying.
I thought it was a sin to lie. I didn't think pastors, a man of God, is supposed to lie.
He's supposed to be an example. Hold on. Get that. Timothy's. How he's supposed to be.
I mean,
a bishop.
Bishop, okay, yeah.
They don't use, some of them use bishop, some of them use pastor.
This is 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 2. A bishop then must be blameless.
He must be blameless. This bishop is not blameless. He's getting caught in all kind of stuff, lies. A bishop, a pastor, he must be blameless. Like, you can't print out what he's doing. Read.
The husband of one wife.
A husband of one wife. A lot of these pastors got all kind of women. Read.
Vigilant, sober, of good behavior.
Of good behavior. You think that's good behavior, what he's doing? Read.
Given to hospitality, apt to teach. Not given to wine, no striker, not greedy, a filthy lucre.
I seen this pastor on the news clip. I think a woman, they locked him out of the church or whatever, and I think she tried to push him or something. He punched her, almost knocked out. Talking about, she hit me. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Read on.
This is 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 3. Not given to wine, nor striker, nor greedy of filthy lucre.
That no greedy of filthy. That's what they are. They greedy.
Money, money, money.
Money.
That's all they about. And Farrakhan ain't no different. I'm just glad to say that. These Islam brothers, they teach it for hire too.
Listen, I want to know where they at when he was down. Malcolm X when he was down, they left him. When Muhammad Ali was down, they left him. Wasn't Mike Tyson with them as well? It was all over.
Yeah.
What they at now? When his career was going all down and busted, they ghost. Every time they be with a so-called, I don't even want to say that, but when they be with they believers or whatever they want to call them, because they're not real much. Listen, bro.
And I just see the comment on Periscope. I got to address this. I can't pray for you, sister, because it's not biblical to have a boyfriend. You ain't supposed to have no boyfriend. That's why you're having a difficult time. I'm sorry to tell you that. God ordained marriage, not boyfriend and girlfriend. That's whoring yourself out for a man that isn't trying to make you his wife. That is not biblical. That is not supposed to be.
Now watch this. I know that sound harsh. I know that sound harsh, but sister, that's love. And this is what the pastors won't tell you. They won't tell you straight, like, listen, you ain't supposed to have a boyfriend. You're supposed to have a husband. They won't tell you that. So when you hear it from a true man of God, you feel offended. You feel it ain't right. Because you haven't heard nobody tell you the truth before. You don't know how it is for somebody to show you real love.
She has a boyfriend, she don't know this. If you are Black, Hispanic, and Native American descent, you are an Israelite according to the Bible. You are God's chosen people, and it's time for you to repent, keep God's commandments. Go to IsraelUnite.org and learn more.
Learn more.
Because the reason why you have a boyfriend, the reason why you're going through a hard time, sisters, because you really don't know what's required of you. You have no idea. You're walking through this world aimlessly. You have no sense of self. You have no self-esteem. That's why you wouldn't get a boyfriend, to validate you. And that's a lot of our sisters. Learn who you are first. Keep God's commandments in the faith of Christ.
Right.
And then, if the Most High will bless you with a husband, then so. But right. That should not be your focus right now.
Right.
At all. Filthy Luca. He's greedy, a Filthy Luca playoff. You got that DJ Amakizi playoff.
Shoes, I don't want, but I don't usually buy my suits from these very expensive places. I just get the things that I invest in will last longer, like such as belts.
So you got the Gucci or places like that?
Well, no, this, I buy those things from there because they have a better TV appearance for the belt.
For asking for money from the poor? You paid $1,000 to Monsieur Clothing in New York. And then another 715. Whose clothing was that for?
What is that now? August 1st.
August 1st.
They got the
total of over $1,700 to Monsieur.
$1,700
in New York.
I don't know about that.
Right, you testified at your last deposition that the JMMI owns 3 vehicles: a BMW, a Mercedes, and a Bentley.
Yes.
Have you driven those cars?
Yes.
Yes.
Is Michelle?
No. We usually have a driver.
The 3 cars that we've talked about, in whose name are the titles?
Ministry.
They're all in JMMI.
I think everything except the Bentley.
Whose name is the Bentley in?
It's in DeWin McDill.
I have a question just for my... You know, you mention the poor and the sick and all that. Isn't it a little offensive to be driving around in a Bentley and a Mercedes to people that really, are impoverished and sick and ill and AIDS and drug rehab? Isn't it a little offensive to sort of being showplacing what you have?
Well, you're one I don't.
The pastor's name is David E. Taylor. That's his name.
I don't do that.
But it's in the ministry. Everybody in the ministry sees you. You said you drive it.
I have before. You just asked me if I drove it. But it ain't something I drive every day or even every year. I don't do that.
Stop.
I have drivers.
Listen, hold on. I just want to say this. To you all... who don't know what Bentley is an exotic car.
It's a $1 million car. It's a $1 million car. A Bentley is $1 million.
It's $300,000.
It is?
It's $300,000.
$300,000.
The Bugatti is $1 million.
Okay, that's what I was thinking of.
The Bugatti, that's the, you was close. Well, we don't know that. Well, I know it because before I came to, I was into all that stuff. But the Bentley, now the Bentley can go up to like, 425, 450, depends what you get in the inside, you know. Hey, listen, they all look the same. What that dude name is, the rapper, Baby,
No Way,
Lil Baby. He just got him a Bentley. He spent $1 million on that one, but he had a whole lot of stuff done to it. You have to have a lot of stuff done to it before you pay $1 million for it. But the base price is $300,000. Mm.
And guess what? He said he doesn't drive it a lot. So he has a $300,000 car that just sits in a garage.
And guess what? He probably don't drive it. He probably gets chauffeured in it. So he was probably like, I'm not lying. I don't drive it.
Right.
Much. I drive it probably like, well, I can't find my chauffeur.
Right, right.
He said it to himself in his head.
This is pimping. This is what pimping gets you. And if you've been pimped in church, this is what your pastors is doing with the money. They might not be on the level of a Bentley, but please believe, your pastor's probably driving a better car than most of the people in this congregation.
Yes.
Guarantee it.
It's different levels. It's different levels. Don't be like, well, it's not my pastor. My pastor drive. He drive a Lexus. He ain't drive no good. Listen, you drive a Lexus. He drive a Lexus. His wife driving a BMW. They going to the gates of where you can't go in. Cause they got them gated community everywhere you go.
And I guarantee they don't have no other job than being your pastor on Sunday.
They don't have no job.
You work five or six days a week, and he worked one day a week and living better than you.
A lot of people don't know Christ had a job. But a lot of people don't know that.
No, they don't.
Cause I want to say, I want to bring this out about these pastors and these preachers and these so-called prophets. And I don't even want to get on the women, the women preachers and prophets. And
we got to.
What's her name?
Juanita Bynum.
Juanita Bynum. What she called it? She had a sermon called Sheets. Like one of her first sermons, I think, was called Sheets.
I never heard that.
Undercover Sheets, something like that. Look it up, bro. Look up Lena Bond or whatever her name is, first sermon. I guarantee you're going to do something with Sheets. Because she was a whore or something. She changed her life. Give me that scripture.
Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 21. I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran.
Mosiah said, I haven't sent these prophets, but yet they ran. Yet they gonna go in my name. I haven't sent these prophets. Read.
I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesied.
I have not said nothing to these people, but yet they prophesied. See, y'all didn't know that was in the Bible. Y'all didn't know that. You so-called Christians, y'all didn't know that was there. You didn't know people were gonna come up and lie to you. Read.
Verse 22. But if they had stood in my counsel.
If they stood in God's counsel, meaning his Bible, that's his counsel. He ain't just coming to you, you standing in the middle of the street like this. Or some doggone field or wherever you sitting at, or in your basement or your house, wherever. He ain't just coming to you out of osmosis. He ain't just popping in your head like you just standing up there like this. Yeah. I hate God. What else, God? Yes, God. What else, God? Yes. What the hell? That's what's going on. I don't know what they're doing. You ain't standing in his counsel. Read.
And had caused my people.
No, read it from the top again.
But if they had stood in my counsel.
If you stood in God's counsel, if you were in the scriptures, if you stood in God's counsel, this would have happened. Read.
And had caused my people to hear my words.
That's the thing. You got to cause God's people, you blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, who are the Israelites, to hear his word. His word. Hold on. Hold it. Give me Romans 3. Romans 3 and verse 3.
Romans chapter 3, verse 3. But what if some did not believe?
They don't have a lot of people don't believe. So what if some don't believe? What if they don't believe in the Bible? That Christ is black? That the blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans who fit the curses in Deuteronomy chapter 28, 15 and down through 68, that God is a so-called black man. It's in the Bible. Ask me to prove it. Read on.
Shall their unbelief make the faith of God without effect?
Should they unbelief make the God, like, because you don't believe God ain't coming back black. That you ain't the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans ain't the Israelites, because you don't believe. That don't mean, God don't care nothing about that. Read.
God forbid. Yea, let God be true.
Let God be true. If this is nonsense, get off here then. Why are you listening to nonsense? How stupid you is. You, just get me. These people, this is dumb. This is, well, let the dummies be on the dumb periscope and you leave. How about that? Is this so dumb and stupid? Oh, this is garbage. Why are you watching garbage? No, you mad. Watch this. Hold on. Watch this. You mad. Keep reading.
God forbid. Yay. Let God be true.
Let God be true. Meaning this Bible speaks about the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. In the so-called Haitians, the so-called Dominicans, who else?
Blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans. That goes for those that live in the Caribbean, Puerto Rico, the islands.
Right. You are the true children of God. You are the true children of God. Read on.
God forbid. Yeah, let God be true.
Let God be true. How you let God be true? By speaking his word. Not your own words, by his word. Read.
But every man a liar.
Every man a liar.
As it is written.
What?
As it is written.
You got to keep it as it is written. Come on.
That thou mightest be justified in thy sayings.
That's how you're going to be justified in your sayings. Come on.
And by this overcome when thou art judged.
Now go back.
Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 22. But they had stood in my counsel and had caused my people to hear my words.
His people to hear his words. Not everybody, not the whole world. Not Esau, the so-called white man. Ain't saying for you. Come on.
Then they should have turned them from their evil way.
They should turn them from their evil way. From them wearing pants, men wearing dresses. You're killing each other. The hatred you got for each other. Ain't no more boyfriend and girlfriend. This is the stuff that your pastor is supposed to be teaching you. Not money all day long. Money, money, money. Money, money. That's all they preach about. They can't preach about nothing else.
They can't. And somebody put, oh, Periscope, this is funny. Too bad your God is a racist. No, the God of this Bible is a racist. Give me that in that.
No, Amos. Too bad. No, I'm glad.
Look, watch this. Give me Amos chapter 3, verse 1. Read that real quick.
He said, thank God. All praises to God.
Now, matter of fact, give me Isaiah 40. Let's just go ahead and go to Isaiah 40. Let's go to Isaiah 40. Because he said, too bad your God is a racist. No, too bad the God, too bad for you, is a racist.
Hey, guess what? It's too bad for you. I'm happy about it.
You got it?
I'm happy about that thing.
Isaiah chapter 40, verse 15. Behold, the nations are as a drop of a bucket.
They are of a what?
A drop of a bucket.
That don't sound like God loves everybody. Come on.
And are counted as the small dust of the balance.
Every nation other than Israel is counted as the small dust of the balance. Meaning it doesn't weigh nothing. Come on.
Behold, he taketh up the isles as a very little thing.
He takes up life as a very little thing. Come on.
and Lebanon is not sufficient to burn.
The landmass of Lebanon isn't even sufficient for a burnt offering to God. He won't accept it. Come on.
Nor the beasts thereof sufficient for a burnt offering.
Not even their animals are sufficient enough for a burnt offering. Come on.
All the nations before him are as nothing.
All of the nations before him is like what?
Nothing.
What?
Nothing.
Come on.
And they are counted to him less than nothing.
They're even in the negative with God. They count it as less than nothing. Mm. That's the Most High God of the Bible. Mm. This is in the Bible. This is in the Bible. So, did we make it up? No. It's Isaiah 40, 15. So, too bad the God for you.
He ain't saying that no more. He gone.
Yeah, he gone.
He gone.
He out.
That's all we got to do with them. Like Esau, hear the truth. He turned red and ghost.
They couldn't believe that's in the Bible. Some of our brothers and sisters, you know, that don't know that they Israel didn't know that was in the Bible. That's in the Bible. We're going over these pimping pastors, but what is a priest supposed to do? What is a pastor supposed to do? Give me Malachi 2 and 7. This is what is supposed to happen.
Malachi chapter 2 and verse 7. For the priest's lips should keep knowledge, and they should seek the law at his mouth.
And he should seek the law at the pastor's mouth. The law is supposed to come out of a pastor's mouth. Not prosperity doctrine. Not acceptance for homosexuals. Not whoremongering. It should be the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God. That's all they should be preaching. You know why? Because that's what all the apostles preached. That's what all the apostles preach. Watch this. Give me Amos 3 and 1. Because dude's still here. He love conquers all, right? Let's see who he love. Let's see who he's dealing with. He said we took that out of context. So-called Christians kill me, bro. Read that.
Amos chapter 3, verse 2.
Listen good.
You only have I known of all.
No, start at verse 1.
Verse 1. Amos chapter 3, verse 1. Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel.
So, go ahead, bro.
So he's speaking against us, the children of Israel, which are the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Let's do this. Listen to me. I know religion has taught you that the fundamentals of grammar and literature that you learned in school the time you went to school is out of the window. It doesn't matter. But it does. That's why it's written in a book. The context of this is saying that the Lord speaking against a certain people, Israel. Read on.
O children of Israel, against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying.
The family of Israel who he brought up out of Egypt. Come on.
You only.
God said, you only. Come on.
Have I known of all the families of the earth?
You only have I known out of all the families of the earth. So it's Israel and everybody else. He only knew Israel out of all the families of the earth. Come on.
Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities.
That's why the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans went through the curses of Deuteronomy 28 for our iniquities.
Now, he said you a joke, but you only read the word.
Right.
He only read the word of God.
He's a scoffer, bro, but guess what? He has heard this day the truth.
But so, I'm just telling you this. You just call him, he a joke, but he only read the Bible. So you call him the Bible. So you joke. Ain't, listen, are you a believer?
No, he's not.
You're not a believer in this Bible because he only read the Bible. He didn't say none of his own words. What are you talking about?
Watch this. Give me Matthew chapter 5, verse 17, because now we done with these pulpit pimpers. All right?
I wanted to bring out a scripture for the preachers. Before we leave the preachers, give me Deuteronomy chapter 13, starting verse 1. I want to just bring this out.
Deuteronomy chapter 13 and verse 1. If there arise among you a prophet, or a dreamer of dreams.
If they rise among you a prophet, a dreamer of dreams, like I said when I was back home, people come out, God gave me a dream last night to tell you this. Don't even know me. Read.
And giveth thee a sign or a wonder.
give you a sign or a wonder. Come on.
And the signs or the wonder come to pass.
Oh, and it comes to pass. Watch this. Read.
Whereof he spake unto thee, saying, let us go after other gods.
Now, he's not going to literally say, leave Jesus. He's going to be deceptive. He's going to, in his actions, by not keeping the commandments, you following other gods. Read.
Which thou hast not known, and let us serve them. Thou should not hearken unto the words of that prophet.
So he's saying, if a man come to you, speaking you a prophecy, and a prophecy come to pass, don't listen to him. Read.
Or the dreamer of dreams.
Or that dreamer of dreams, read.
For the Lord your God proveth you.
He testing you. He want to see if you just going to go with a man or you going to just deal with his words. Read.
To know whether he love.
That's when you know you love God. When you going to choose him over the man. Read. I don't care how smooth he talk. I don't care what he wear. I don't care if it's my mama, my daddy, my brother, my sister, my children. They ain't coming before the Most High God. Read.
To know whether ye love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. You shall walk after the Lord your God.
Walk after the Lord your God means keep the commandments. Read.
And fear him and keep his commandments and obey his voice, and ye shall serve him and cleave unto him. And that prophet or that dreamer of dreams shall be put to death because he has spoken to turn you away from the Lord your God.
They believe that this is done away with. No, if you stay in this, if this prophet or this dreamer of dreams stay in this state, they don't repent. Only the blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans can do this. But if they don't repent, you're going to die. This is not done away with.
Nope.
Read.
It says, to turn you from the Lord your God, which brought you out of the land of Egypt and redeemed you out of the house of bondage, to thrust thee out of the way which the Lord thy God commanded thee to walk in. So thou shalt be put, it says, so shalt thou put the evil away from the midst of thee.
You can't be perfect. He telling you to stop doing evil. Ain't murdering evil? Well, you can't be perfect. So I'm just going to have to murder you. Come on, man. How y'all sound? Well, I have to have sex with her, bro. I can't be perfect. I got to have sex with her. I can't be perfect. What are you talking about? I got to steal this. I got to steal, bro.
Right.
I can't. Right. I got to hate you. I can't be perfect. I got to hate you. I hate you. That's how y'all sound when y'all say you can't be perfect. This is what the stuff he telling you not to do.
Right.
Read on. Because watch this. Because this is when y'all get sensitive.
Verse 6.
They get sensitive right here. They can't lose these people.
Deuteronomy chapter 13, verse 6. If thy brother, the son of thy mother, or thy son, or thy daughter, or the wife of thy bosom, or thy friend, which is as thy own soul, entice thee secretly, saying, Let us go and serve other gods, which thou hast not known, thou nor thy fathers, namely of the gods of the people which are around about you, nigh unto thee, or far off from thee.
What verse you at?
I'm at verse 7.
No, I wanted just verse 6.
Okay, verse 6. If thy brother, the son of thy mother, or thy son, or thy daughter, or thy wife of thy bosom, or thy friend, which is as thy own soul, entice thee secretly, saying, let us go and serve other gods, which thou hast not known, thou nor thy fathers.
Let me tell you this. Our fathers didn't know Christmas, birthdays, New Year's, 4th of July, Thanksgiving, Halloween. all these pagan things, anything that the so-called white man, that we, our people worship. We didn't do this stuff. And the Most High said, Christ said the same thing. Who my brother? Who my father? Those who keep the commandments. This is the same wording. I don't care if it's your mother, your brother, your sister, your daughter, your friend. It doesn't matter. You got something to say, Austin?
You hit the, you said.
I just wanted to finish up on the pastors, the dreamers. That's it.
Matthew 5:17, because we got to get the point. Because a lot of pastors will say that the Old Testament is done away with. They'll say that you won't have to keep the commandments because Jesus Christ came and died, so we wouldn't have to do that anymore. You've been lied to. You've been pimped. Because if they say the law is, how do they say the law is done away with but still charge you tithes? How can they say tithes and offering when offering and tithes have been done away with too?
If the right.
Read Matthew 5.
All that's in the Old Testament.
Our people is checked out, man. They lost.
Matthew 5:17. Think not that I come to destroy the law or the prophets. I have not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
This is Jesus the Christ, the black Messiah, saying he didn't come to destroy the law. He didn't come and destroy what the prophets said in the Old Testament. He didn't come to destroy it. He came to fulfill what was written of him, that he must suffer and die for the nation of Israel. Read.
For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall in no wise pass from the law, till all be fulfilled.
So we're still on heaven. We're still on earth. There's still a heaven above us. We're still on earth. It said not one jot or tittle shall pass from the law. So the law is still here, because we're still here. Come on.
Verse 19. Whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments.
What's the least commandment? A woman wearing pants when she should be wearing a dress. A man that wears a dress that should be wearing pants. That's the least commandment. A man should have a beard on his face. A man and a woman should both have fringes on their clothing. It said if a man don't keep the least commandment, come on.
And shall teach men so.
And teach men so. Meaning in your actions, in the way you conduct yourself, in your preaching. The law's done away with. You are discounting the least commandments. All the commandments. Come on.
He shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven.
He shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven. Somebody might read that and be like, he's still going to make it. Keep reading on.
But whosoever shall do and teach them, the same shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven.
So we go out to these highways and hedges and teach the commandments of God. And the faith in Jesus Christ. And we keep the commandments of God in the faith in Jesus. Read on. So we're going to be called great in the kingdom of heaven. Come on.
Verse 20. For I say unto you, that except your righteousness shall be exceeded the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees, ye shall in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven.
He said, if your righteousness doesn't pass the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees, which were the religious leaders, the leaders of the people at that time for guidance, biblical guidance, they ain't gonna make it, because Jesus just said that the scribes and Pharisees are hypocrites. They don't do what they say they do. They preach the commandments, but they don't keep the commandments. If your righteousness don't pass theirs, you will never see the kingdom of heaven. So let's bring it up to today's.
And then it'll talk about you a Pharisee. He telling you to be better than them.
Right. But guess what? So if your righteousness don't pass the righteousness of your pastor, you ain't going to make it. Why? Because your pastor ain't going to make it. Your evangelist ain't going to make it. Your deacon ain't going to make it. Why? Because they're not keeping the commandments.
You? He gonna make it.
Right.
You following them.
And give me Matthew 7:21. Because this is what happens. They say, oh, Jesus came in to do away with that. All you need to do is believe in the name of Jesus. Or Yahweh Shai. Same difference. Or Yoshua. You have to say the name. Ak.
The Bible says the demons, they believe. And tremble with fear. So would you
but the Christians are caught up on the name, and some of these camps is caught up on a name. And we ain't even. Oh, read that, please. I'm sick of these people. Both ends. Come on.
Matthew chapter 7, verse 21. Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord.
Yahweh Shah. Jesus. Come on.
Shall enter into the kingdom of heaven.
Shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. That doctrine is shot to death right there. Come on.
It says, but he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven.
The will of the Father is keeping God's commandments. That's Psalms 40 and 8. That's the will of God. Come on.
Verse 23. And then will I profess unto them.
No, read 22.
Verse 22. Many will say to me in that day.
That day is that when Christ come back. That's the day he's talking about. Come on.
Lord, Lord. Have we not prophesied in thy name?
Yahweh Shah. Did we stand on the block and say, Yahweh Bim, Yahweh Shah? Or your pastor saying, Lord, didn't I have a mega church of 50 million members? Come on.
And in thy name have we cast out devils.
That's your Benny Hinn. Didn't I say Jesus and I hit them and they passed out for you? Come on.
And in thy name done many wonderful works.
That's that pulpit pimping as they call wonderful works. That ha shabada people passing out. What was Jesus gonna say to them? Read.
And then will I profess unto them.
Well, now this is Christ saying something to them after they just said all of that. Come on.
I never knew you.
He what?
I never knew you.
Nah, they were living in the Greater Tabernacle Ebenezer Baptist Church of Life.
With the crackhead on the side.
I never knew you.
Read on.
Depart from me, ye that work iniquity.
Iniquity is sin. So guess what? Christ is going to say he never knew you and he's going to kill you. Don't get it twisted. He's going to kill you. Isaiah 66. They gonna play it. See, they think that we making this up. He said he never knew you, the workers of iniquity. Let's read what's going on. Let's go read exactly what's going to happen. We gonna read your death in the Bible.
Isaiah chapter 66, verse 15.
If you don't repent, Jesus the Christ will be the one that kill you. Read.
For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind.
The Lord will come with his chariots and fire. Like a whirlwind, come on.
To render his anger with fury.
No, he gonna come with gummy bears, hugs, and kindness and love.
To render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire.
I've never seen a happy, angry person in my life. I don't even, that's an oxymoron. Yeah. You can't be happy and angry at the same time. It's impossible, okay? He said he's coming with his fury and anger. And
I hate you right now.
Rebuke is correction. He's going to correct you with his sword and flames of fire. That's not easy correction. That ain't a correction you can live after. Come on.
For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh.
By fire and with his sword shall he plead with all flesh. Come on.
And the slain of the Lord shall be many.
And the what?
And the slain of the Lord shall be many.
We ain't talking about slain in the spirit like your stupid pimping pastor talk about when you lay out dead. No, you're really going to be dead. Slain by the Lord. He's going to kill you. Come on.
Verse 17. They that sanctify themselves and purify themselves in the garden. Behind one tree in the midst.
Those that purify themselves and sanctify themselves, those are the ones that say, oh, everything we eat is clean. Nothing can be refused. Or, all I'm washed in the blood of the Lamb. I'm clean.
So you can eat human beings.
Right. You can do all of this in the name of Jesus. That's all you got to say. I do it in the name of Jesus. It makes it right. Okay.
Go eat a cockroach and say in the name of Jesus.
Right. And watch what's going to happen to these people that purify and sanctify themselves. Come on.
Eating swine's flesh.
That's your pastor eat pork chops after church. That's your favorite food to eat after church. I know. I used to go to church.
Hey, They go to
have a church fish fry. Y'all have a catfish fry.
They go to Gordon Corral. The church number they used to go to Gordon Corral.
And eat all type of abominables. All types.
And you're not, and actually you're not even supposed to be going buying and selling. Some of them believe you gotta keep the Ten Commandments. You know the Ten Commandments is the Sabbath day that they don't even keep right. You go straight after church and go buy and sell.
Right. Quick. And
you eat abominable stuff.
Right.
You add sin to sin.
Read on. Read the pork part of eating swine's flesh.
Eating swine's flesh.
Come on.
And the abomination.
Come on.
And the mouse shall be consumed together.
Consumed together. Consumed means taken away. If I consume some food, it's gone. It's destroyed. I ate it. But it's a fire. When fire consumes something, like let's say a house is consumed in fire, there's nothing left. Look, the Bible just said you're going to die, okay? And some people still be up here saying, that's not right. God is love. It just said his anger. So he's not coming back with gummy bears, flowers, and hugs.
First of all,
he's coming to kill people.
Watch this. Well, why is this a hell then?
Those are for those that missed the mark, apparently. Whatever that means.
How you missed the mark? Tell me. Because I don't know how to miss the mark. I don't know what that is. I can't find it in the Bible. I'm trying to find it. Can you find it?
No.
Christians are delusional. They'll come up with some random saying just to make themselves feel, oh, I just missed the mark. What does that mean? The mark wasn't met. You know?
Mark wasn't met. So, you know help. You know help to me.
Like the dude that called in yesterday talking about the Holy Spirit, the different dimensions of the Holy Spirit. What?
Because he's listening to them T.D. Jakes, them Joel Osteens, them...
And I asked him a question. Brother, how do you keep the Sabbath holy? Crickets.
That's what you heard.
But you got the Holy Ghost. But you can't tell me how to keep the Sabbath holy.
They know the dimensions of the Holy Ghost, but don't know how to make it to the kingdom. That don't make no sense.
Give me Matthew chapter 19, verse 16. You know what I want. Because these are basic scriptures that prove to you that your pastor has lied to you and your family. Your time. Do you know where Christianity comes from? It comes from your oppressor who put you in chains. Your first pastor was your slave master.
Right.
If your pastor was Baptist, you Baptist. If he was Methodist,
bring it out,
you Methodist. If you were a Jehovah's Witness,
he was
a Jehovah's Witness.
Bring it out.
We don't want to accept that.
Bring it out.
We don't want to accept that. Come on, read that.
Matthew chapter 19, verse 16.
How is it that he's praying to keep you in chains and you praying to get out of chains to the same white, blue-eyed, streaky-haired Jesus? Does that even make sense? Read on.
And behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good thing shall I do that I may receive eternal life?
So this man asked, as Christ said, good master, what good things may I do to have eternal life? The question is, how do I make it to the kingdom of heaven?
Exactly.
That is the question that everybody in church should be asking and should get an answer for.
Right.
Read on.
Verse 17. And he said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God.
So Jesus gave all glory to the Most High God, the Father, the Heavenly Father, letting you know that there is a difference between the Father and Jesus the Christ. They're not one being. They're separate. Read.
But if thou wilt enter into life.
If you want to enter into life, enter into the kingdom of heaven, eternal life forever, what do you have to do?
Keep the commandments.
Oh my gosh, a Christian head just blew up. You got to do what?
Keep the commandments.
No, Creflo Dollar said me keeping the commandments is me falling into sin, and in order for me to fall into grace, I must not keep the commandments. What did Jesus Christ the righteous say?
Keep the commandments.
So you mean to tell me, brother, I got to give this woman I got on the side of?
Got to. Must.
It feel good, though.
And? What?
You know what? I'm taking my money, and I'm leaving.
Bye. Shalom.
See, that's what the pastors don't want. So they're not going to tell you the truth. They're not going to tell a homosexual, and I'm going to tell you this. This is what I found out too. The homosexuals, they pay their tithes. They pay big money. And if you open your mouth against a homosexual, guess what? They'll shut you down. They'll leave. Listen, they'll leave. Not only that, the following, remember when it was Chick-fil-A?
Yeah.
Chick-fil-A said, you know, they said something about
gay. We don't accept gay people. We don't believe it. Because, you know, the Chick-fil-A owner is highly religious.
Right.
And Christianity. That's why it closed on Sunday.
Right. You know what I'm saying? I mean, they off as hell.
They off as hell.
But they got some concept of a backbone or something to say something.
But guess what? That all is null and void because now they hire gay people. They have to.
Right. Because, you know, but when it, I'm just going to bring the point that when it happened, guess what them gays did?
Boycotted Chick-fil-A.
And that's what the pastors don't want. They ain't going through all that what Chick-fil-A went through. They ain't going to do that. Look, you say anything about a gay person, even the rappers are scared.
No, some of them are the man fans anyway.
Listen, some of you rappers are scary. No. Because y'all say, no homo, look, I got nothing against the gays. You comedians too. Before you make a joke, I don't got nothing against you gays. Don't come after me.
95% of all rappers in the world are gay. I'm highly convinced of that. They have things like the pastors. They have homosexual connotations.
And they even talk like pastors. When somebody asks him, I was watching an interview where a dude was asking how you feel about your counterparts, you know, the other rappers, wearing dresses and stuff. Well, you can't judge people. And this is the same dude talking about killing and robbing and sleeping with So you judging? You gonna keep that? You gonna keep that's honorable? But all the rest of the stuff you gonna keep doing?
Give me a.
Don't make no doggone sense, man.
It doesn't. It's sick. Give me Revelations. We almost out of time. Give me Revelation 22:14. Because Christ said you must keep the commandments to get eternal life to get the kingdom of heaven. Is there it that? But somebody might say, "Oh, that's before he died." Let's read about after death and resurrection. What the Bible says. Give me that.
Revelation chapter 22:14. Blessed are they that do his commandments.
Blessed are they that do, not just say, do his commandments. Come on.
That they may have the right to the tree of life.
That they may have the right to the tree of life. Come on.
And may enter in through the gates into the city.
The gates of the city, there's 12 gates, and each gate has a name of a tribe of Israel. That's in 21. That's in Revelation 21. Read on.
For without are dogs.
Without are dogs, heathen, come on.
And sorcerers.
Sorcerers, so it's going into things that won't let you into the kingdom of heaven.
Mm-hmm.
So the commandments have been here and will always be here for you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. You go through what you go through because you don't keep the commandments. And your pastor makes his living off of destroying you by telling you there is no commandments to keep. That's why you have the worst jobs. You live in poverty. You have a drug-ridden community. You have women have babies having babies. Say it like that. You don't have fathers in the home. You don't have mothers in the home anymore because they too busy clubbing. And they all go to church on Sunday. Sister Maddie Patterson, Sister Maddie, has born a generation of monsters, and she's always been in church every Sunday. I'm talking about the 50, 60-year-old woman. She has a son on crack. She has a grandson in jail. She has a daughter that got pregnant at 15.
And she's messy as hell. She's everybody's business.
She the one in church with the flower hat on, with rings on every finger, and her nails this long. Talk about praise God with the fan. That goes to show you that the Christian church is a joke.
Give me that, officer, what I called earlier. I'm just my last one.
Matthew chapter 22:36.
Because a lot of people say he only has two commandments. Christ only has, he gave two commandments. That's it. Read.
Matthew chapter 22.
So you can kill in adultery? No, you can't. Read that.
Master, which is the great commandment in the law?
They was tempting, they were trying to trick Christ up. That's what this question was for. He said, Master, what is the greatest law of them all?
Jesus said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart.
He said, out all of them, God should love, you should love God with all your heart. That's one of out of all. Read.
And with all thy soul and with all thy mind.
Read.
This is the first and great commandment.
This is the first and great commandment. Read.
And the second is like unto it.
The second one is like unto it. It's like, it's the same one. It's the same thing. Read.
Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
You should love your brother as yourself.
On these two.
Now watch. But they leave it alone. They stop right there. They don't keep reading. But we're going to keep reading here. What?
On these two commandments.
On these two commandments.
Hang all the law.
Hang what?
All the law.
All.
The law.
All the law. Meaning, how you love that guy? You're not going to worship other gods. You're not going to put no other god before him.
You're going to keep his high holy days.
You're going to keep his Sabbaths. Your brother. I'm not going to cheat on his wife. I'm not going to steal from him. I'm not going to kill from him. I'm not going to kill him.
Right.
That's how you would. He said, on these two, hang all the laws. That's it on that?
Someone just put, I want to come. Okay, so go to IsraelUnite.org. We have classes 3 times a day, 7 days a week. We have camps or schools in every city, almost worldwide. Almost. So go there. There's contact us information. Contact the person that is the head in your state so that you can congregate. All praise to the Most High. That's
all praise.
That's one step towards repentance. All praise to the Most High.
If I do this every day in one person, I'm ecstatic.
We doing our job. But it's 12 o'clock.
Wait, y'all. I just want to finish that off before you go. Just finish the one off, bro. Before we go.
On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
And the prophets, meaning the Old Testament not done away with. And the prophets. So that's it.
Today is the deadline for, Fader said, today is the deadline to register for Feast of Tabernacles. Again, y'all don't want to miss out on this. Men's Conference is also in there. Also, Adonis and Sarah is also having a meeting there as well. It's going to be beautiful, y'all. We got everything planned out for you.
Did you say the Men's Conference?
Yeah, I said Men's Conference.
I know what this one is.
Okay, yeah.
I'm messing with it.
Yeah. We got a lot
I'm excited about it, bro. I'm excited about that thing because I always, men's conference is big, man. That's a big thing because you learn more. You learn how to be a husband. You know how to be a man in his truth.
Right. So fade us in, officer, with some beautiful music to fade us out. Tonight is new moon in the memorial of blowing the trumpets.
Mm-hmm.
No buying, working, selling at sundown. None. Keep the commandments, y'all.
That's right.
It's a double Sabbath. So we're going right into the normal Sabbath, as you know, Friday sundown.
Right.
No buying until Saturday sundown.
Right.
No working till Saturday sundown. If you can, Lord's will, you can. Let's keep the commandments, y'all, in faith in Jesus. We gone. Shalom, Israel.
I'm Officer Yahusah.
And I'm Officer Abiyah.
I love you all. Israel, I love you. My brothers and sisters.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Oh, yeah, there's no cooking Friday sundown to Saturday sundown. You can cook Thursday tonight. Friday night has to stop. All cooking has to stop Friday night.
So you got to prepare.
Shalom.